Yoo-hoo. Can't believe I said that. Orville, you in that sound stall over there?
Yeah, Pastor. What do you need?
Well, I'm troubled. Ever since that mud of Lorraine's done saved us alongside of that sheepherder and his flock, there's no hearing the end of it.
Pastor, that dog was your guardian angel.
I know, but she went and sewed a little red beanie on it and everything.
Yoo-hoo, Pastor!
Well, speak of the devil.
He's probably the one who done it.
Done what?
Took away my dog.
Huh?
Yeah, Fido, he's gone.
Now, Sister Lorraine, brace up, step up a lip. It's going to be all right. Your Fido is, after all, a dog. And dogs do what dogs do and do. And so, the whole point is that maybe he smelt a rabbit and took off after it to check it out.
No. He's been gone 2 days, Pastor. He's always home for supper and a tummy rub, like clockwork.
Yeah, I understand, but I hate to say this, but you know, there's one possibility you may not have considered or wanted to think about.
Well, Pastor, please don't go there.
No, no. What I'm trying to say is that that dog of yours, he told us he was a secret agent. Do you remember that?
Yeah, I know. But you know, I also remember that issue with the pistol lady, even though he was a talker, only wanted $10. I said, why? She said, well, he was a liar, because he never did all the things and went to them places. He'd never been nowhere besides West Texas at the time.
Well, imagine there's a lot of tricks that a dog could learn down there.
Yeah, some of the girls say there's a whole bunch of tricks down there.
I suppose they're down there dispensing treats. Anyway, the point is, Lorraine, we need a plan of action here. That pup really is gone. I mean, I'm going to be pretty upset too, even though he does like to piddle on my boot.
I think he's just marking his territory, Pastor.
Well, I ain't no tree.
No, but you know, Fido prefers fire plugs. In fact, he owns a whole neighborhood full of them.
Well, that's a skill, I suppose.
If the hydrant's busted and he can pass the urine test.
Anyway, he may well be out on some special mission for some national agency. You never know, Lorraine.
Oh, Pastor, do you really think so?
I do.
I mean, it's breaking my heart.
Try a little blind faith, Sister Lorraine. Like a blind date.
Huh?
Well, you listen to the gospel airs practicing in the practice rehearsal stall over there. Maybe they could sing a little something to cheer you up. Hey, fellas, I really need your help over here. Sister Lorraine's losing it.
Oh, Fido.
She's lost a dog.
My puppy.
Oh, no. Yeah, could you guys come in here and sing something to cheer up?
She'll be right there, boss.
Say, Lorraine, how about a nice glass of punch?
Oh, Fido.
Go easy, boys.
We generally do for Cowboy Church broadcast, Pastor. We play in fear and trembling.
That we won't be first to the cookies. Like today, if you don't hurry up with this intro. That's it. Go ahead and punish me.
I saw her today. I saw her face. It was a face I loved. And I knew I had to run away. And get down on my knees and pray that they'd go away, but still they begin. Those needles and pins, because of all my pride, the tears I gotta hide. Hey, if I was ever small, I'd wanna hawk. Think I did, but now I see she's worse to him than me.
Oh,
go ahead, take it off.
I think you are too. You try this one.
No, no, please. Please go ahead.
Get down on her knees. Hey, that's how it begins. She'll feel those needles and pins. Why can't I stop and tell myself I'm wrong, I'm wrong, so wrong? Why can't I stand up and tell myself I'm wrong? I'm strong. Because I saw her today. Saw her face. It was a face I loved. And I knew I had to run away. And get down on my knees and pray. And I pray your way. Till they begin. And because of all my crying, now the tears I gotta hide. Needles and pins, needles and pins, needles and pins, needles and pins.
Seen.
Fido, why did you leave?
Well, as you know, I'm a retired emissary from on high. Of course, that doesn't prevent me from paying up a little annuity change once in a while when the high head wants something done. He makes an offer and don't want to refuse it. And there was no point in telling you I was leaving because you'd ask a bunch of questions I couldn't answer. Besides, I can't write, I only got paws.
Well, I want to know what happened.
Since it ain't a problem, I'll talk about it.
Fido, I want to know what happened now.
Okay, okay. It all started kind of like this.
Phoebe the Fearless and I've been coupled a few times on previous occasions. We called them E-missions because they were by executive order. Anyway, we got caught once or twice. Once they even gave us a rubber hose treatment, but for the most part, she was a stalwart agent for Angel Eyes Investigations.
Oh, right, Private Eyes, huh?
Yeah, that's the idea, but we get a bird's eye view. Anyway, she and I had gotten in an argument of all things, child development. I was an advocate of spare the rod and you spoil the pup. But she insisted that a rolled up newspaper would work just fine. Anyway, I hadn't seen her for a while. Then I was out in front of your dance studio, you know, next to the radio station, and I saw a repair van out there. And I knew from my previous espionage experience and seeing a couple of spy movies, of course, that meant that you were under surveillance and I had to do something about it. So first I marked their tires so we'd be able to find them again. Then I hightailed it on down to headquarters to talk to Fifi. You know, she's done been promoted. She runs the division now. They got no glass ceilings up there. Anyway, Fifi done pulled out a dossier and she told me about an international plot to take over the airwaves. And I knew that was a bad thing because National Prozac Radio is just a front for the put them to sleep lullaby news hour where they put you into a trance with the same old blood and gut stuff. It's the opiate of the masses.
Opiate what?
It lulls their senses, which of course just to build up a dependency so the pharmaceutical companies can take over. Anyway, them boys in that repair van was professionals. They look just like the regular fellas that don't do nothing but lean on a shovel or something. So anyhow, Phoebe and I have been down there surveilling them back. And that's when it happened.
What happened?
Them boys were dog catchers, and they nabbed me. Phoebe tried to help, but they almost got her. They took me to an isolation cell at the dog pound, and that's when they went to it.
Torture?
Yeah, mental torture. They kept teasing me with a dog biscuit. And I'll admit I was pretty hungry, but I was afraid it might have some kind of narcotic in it.
Like what? Truth serum?
Truth for to tell, Pastor. There's some family secrets around here that don't bear repeating.
Like what?
Well, how about genealogy? One thing, you being the son of a... for instance.
Fido!
Well, I hear most male dogs are, too.
This time I happened to step on my own.
Pastor?
So what happened next? How'd you get here?
Well, that's a long story, but to tell you the truth, we don't have time for that right now.
Why's that?
My mission, Pastor, was to delay the last trump.
Why? What happened to the first one? Eyes have not heard nor ears seen the likes of him. Not since.
Pastor Yola's Dixie is kicking in. That last verse was Bass Atwood's.
Well, I escaped. How did you do that?
With the help of a chihuahua. I had him distract the warden but on his ankle, and he thought it was his house warden.
Fido!
Hell, you... I guess I better fess up. Phoebe, my beloved, come on in here.
Hello. Do you all parlez-vous la français?
Oh, she's a little you.
Sister Lorraine, that dog's seen you out of house and home as it is. How are you going to support this?
I call her little me.
Little one of the little issue. You remember how I told you? When I retired, I had a mess of puppies. Well, they're all teenagers now, and they're out in the yard chasing the pastor's chickens.
Sister Lorraine? Yes, VP? Is it true that you are the madame whom my Fido serves so faithfully here?
Well, I guess so. Usually I serve him about 3 times a day.
Well, he is so funny. All these adventures he describes. He's just been down at my master's house.
Where's that?
Oh, this is the Fallen from Grace Cathedral. You all know of Bishop M.T. Tallywacker, do you not?
Don't listen to her. She sworn to silence. It's all top secret, you know, and,
Now, see here. We've all been on pins and needles about you here for the past couple of days.
Because of all your pride, the tears we had to hide.
Okay, I thought it was smart. I'd won Vivi's heart. Didn't know what to do. But now I see. I just made things worse for me. And so I'll go. Come on, Vivi.
No, I don't think so, dear. I like it here. And besides, it's very near, so you can babysit.
What about you?
Well, she needs you too. Why can't you stand up and tell yourself you're wrong?
I'm wrong, so wrong.
Bad puppy.
Well, then, stand up and tell yourself you're strong.
We all need you today. We see your face. We know that face. It's one we love. So don't run away.
But I get down on my knees and pray.
Till they begin. Those needles and pins up. The tears we gotta hide.
Okay, I guess I'll stay. Can I get tummy rubs every day?
I'm so happy.
What about all these pups? It's me and make it snappy. This ain't no puppy dog shit farm.
It's Tommy.
Well, come on, we're waiting.
Yes, my darling, I am waiting too. Expectantly.
Okay, guys, I think that's a take. Pretty good radio show, I think, this
pretty
time.
Pretty good. Yeah, boy.
Wait, what about Fifi?
This is a radio show,
yeah,
man.
We gotta get all ready for the pastor to solemnize her vows, and I need to give her a fitting for her wedding dress, but I just went to the sewing box and scratching my head. So, you'll never guess what we're all out of.
Orville. Oops, sorry.